Hi guys, and welcome to my channel Ronam. Today I will tell you 10 video games that impacted gaming. Video games are getting bigger and bigger every year, with the mass production of crapware coming out. There are still a few games released that really change how people game. Whether it's a serious game or more casual, these games really made an impact on video game industry. Number 10. EverQuest. This Sony made MMO, massively multiplayer online, was the first of its kind, and really defined how MMOs are played today. The game's user interface is the standard blueprint for every new MMO that comes out. Sometimes so similar, you can even call it a copy. Regardless, if you loved or hated EverQuest, nobody can deny that. Number 9. StarCraft. The RTS, real-time strategy, video game genre has been defined by this game. With its very high-paced gameplay and a massive online fanbase, it's hard to describe the impact of StarCraft on the gaming industry. In my opinion, with the rise of console gaming, StarCraft is one of those games that really kept PC gaming alive. The game is even televised nationally in Korea. Yes, it's that big. With the release of StarCraft 2, I would imagine the RTS genre will only grow. Number 8. GTA 3. Mothers around the world hate this game. It's a sandbox game that allows you to do literally anything. The game really got heated after the release of San Andreas, particularly because of hot cafe mode shown. The game company had to re-release the game without that scene. Regardlessly, GTA and sandboxes go hand in hand. Number 7. World of Warcraft. With over 10 million players currently and growing, it's easy to see how this game impacted gaming. The mix between satisfying content and the social network involved in this game purely puts it in its own category. There have been reports of suicides conquering this game. Number 6. Legend of Zelda. The mix between RPG, hack and slash, and action or adventure made this game a big hit from its first day of release. Nintendo struck gold with this one, and it is still a major series of the Nintendo platforms today. Not to mention, Link make an appearance in so many other games. That is how loved he really is. Number 5. Doom. Doom franchise was later continued with the follow-up Doom to Hell on Earth and numerous expansion packings, including Master Level of Doom 2 and Final Doom. This series started to lose mainstream appeal as the technology of the Doom game engine was suppressed in the mid-90s. Although fans have continued making VATs, speedruns, and modifications to the original, the franchise again received popular attention in 2004 with the release of Doom 3, a retelling of the original game using ID Tech 4. Number 4. The Sims. The games in the Sims series are largely sandbox games, in that they lack any defined goals, except for some later expansion packs and console version which introduce this gameplay style. The player creates virtual people called Sims and places them in houses and helps direct their moods and satisfy their desires. Player can either place their Sims in pre-constructed homes or build them themselves. Each successive expansion pack and game in this series augmented what the player could do with their Sims. Number 3. The Halo. Microsoft can really thank this series for the huge success of Xbox Live. Sure, I mean, we have Call of Duty now, but nobody can deny what Halo did for the console FPS, first-person shooter. Because of Halo, the use of online console gaming was born with Xbox Live. I can't remember a kid who didn't play Xbox Live with Halo. Number 2. Half-Life. Half-Life is a first-person shooter that requires the player to perform combat tasks and puzzle solving to advance through the game. Half-Life story is told entirely by means of scripted sequence, keeping the game in control of the first-person viewpoint. In line with this, the game has no cutscenes, and the player rarely loses the ability to control Gordon, who never speaks and is never actually seen in the game. The player sees through his eyes for the entire length of the game. Half-Life has no levels. It instead divides the game into chapters, whose titles flash on the screen as the player moves through the game. Progress through the world is continuously. Number 1. Super Mario Bros. Any disputes here? This game from Nintendo started gaming. I know there was the Atari and other system prior too, but Mario made all games what they are today. With a new Mario releasing every year, it's undeniable what this Italian plumber did for gamers all around the world.
I hope you enjoy my video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe my channel.